वेलकम टू आप आईएस। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट टुडेज डिस्कशन ऑफ डेली न्यूज क्रक्स। सो गाइस, व्हाट इज डेली न्यूज क्रक्स? इट इज एन इनिशिएटिव बाय आप आईएस वेयर इन वी ब्रिंग यू द समरी ऑफ पीआईबी, राज्यसभा टीवी, हिंदू, लाइव मिंट, टाइम्स ऑफ इंडिया एंड ऑल इंपॉर्टेंट सोर्सेज दैट आर रिलेवेंट फॉर योर यूपीएससी सिविल सर्विस एग्जाम। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द डिस्कशन एंड लेट्स मूव टुवर्ड्स आवर फर्स्ट आर्टिकल। सो गाइस, इट्स आर्टिकल विच वी डिस्कस्ड यस्टरडे ऑल्सो दैट द कमांडर लेवल मीटिंग्स आर बीइंग गोइंग टू हेल्ड बिटवीन इंडिया एंड चाइना। सो द पॉइंट हियर टू बी नोटेड इज द मीटिंग्स आर हेल्ड इन चुलसुल इन लद्दाख। So UPSC have played many times with regard to the map locations. So you must know that Chulsul is in Ladakh. So along with that, the point here to be noted is that line of actual control. So there is a bit confusion between LAC and LOC. So let's discuss this thing. What is LAC and what are the different territorial disputes of India? So guys, when we talk about the territorial dispute, India is having territorial dispute with Pakistan. So Pakistan occupied forcefully this region, which we call as POK today. And the line here is called LOC. It's LOC. Wherein, if we see this line, here is the area which is claimed by India. It's Aksai Chin region. And some disputed regions which are captured by China. So these regions which we call as Aksai Chin, here we have LAC. So this point must be clear that LAC is with Pakistan and, sorry, LOC is with Pakistan and LAC is with China. Along with that, we are having some disputes in the McMahon line which we have initially with China. So herein we the China claims some part of the Arunachal Pradesh to be its part, but actually Arunachal Pradesh is integral part of India, and this was done in order to, because we were not recognizing the Tibet as a part of China that time, and we gave shelter to Dalai Lama at that time when the China forcefully captured the Tibet. So that's why China claimed Arunachal Pradesh area, so that we can also be in pressure and we recognize the Tibet. So the China was successful in this regard. So I think you must be clear about LAC, LOC and other related aspects to this article. So let's move towards next article. So recently, yesterday, we discussed that the Indian government, using sections of Information Technology Act, banned the 59 apps of India. So here in this regard, the Indian government has given some time to the apps to clarify about the situation and the reasons why they should not be banned under the Information Technology Procedure and Safeguard for Blocking of Access of Information by Public Rules 2009. So herein this much was sufficient for our year exam. So let's move towards the next article, which is very, very important from your exam point of view under the government schemes and initiatives along with the poverty topics under your GS paper. So let us discuss something about Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Anni Yojana. So under this, the central government provided free food supplies to the poor farmers, and recently the government said that this free grain distribution scheme would extended by 5 months till the end of November, and estimated 90,000 crores would be spent on this scheme. So under this scheme, for next 5 years, 5 kg of free rice and wheat and 1 kg of chana will be provided to 80 crore of Indians. So this point must be noted about the PM Garib Kalyan Anna Yojana. So the number would be increased, including these 80 crore peoples. It will be covering estimated 1,100 crore peoples of India, which would be covered under this scheme till now. So let's move to the next article. So next article is about the hog deer. So recently, in Assam's flood prone area, the Kaziranga Park, there was the spottings of the hog deer. So there are 2 points are to be noted. You have to mark Kaziranga National Park in the map. Along with that, you have to see what's the status of hog deer. So we have simplified one thing for you, that what is the status of hog deer, which is fluently asked by UPSC in various prelims exams. So hog deer is endangered species under IUCN Red List, and it's protected under the Schedule 1 of Wildlife Protection Act. So you must note this point. It is a fodder point for your prelims, which will help you to qualify the prelims exam. So note down this point. Let's move towards next article. So this is the article wherein Indian government means the author has depicted the concerns regarding the deletion of the Chinese apps and what actions it may pose, means what could be the consequences of this on Indian side. So you can read it. The discussion PDF would be available in the description box as well as our Telegram channel. So the next article appears in the Hindu is about China being concerned about banning of 59 Chinese apps. So herein the China has asserted that the ban by Indian government is a deliberative interference in the practical cooperation. Wherein the Chinese side has asserted that it would be affecting the Chinese outbound investment in India very badly. And along with that, China has asserted that the practical cooperation between China and India is mutually beneficial in interest of both. But if these effects, means this kind of action would be taken, that would be harmful for both the sides. Along with that, the China here says that the action taken by government of India is not in line with the WTO norms, and India should have a conducive IT policy in lines of international trade and e-commerce, and must be having the open competition as per the laws and norms of WTO. Along with that, the Chinese embassy said that the ban on the apps of China would not only affect the China but also the Indian local as well, because most of the people are engaged in making TikTok. It's my personal suggestion which I have observed. So they have said that it would affect the employment in India as well. So and along with that, the China is saying that the predicted China's overseas direct investment in India would be sharply declining in 2020, and the most expected is 50% reduction in the Chinese export, that is overseas direct investment to India. So next article in the Hindu is the center's focus on online education. So here in the center is focusing more on promoting the people towards the online education, wherein the center has taken measures to include the basic water and sanitation hygiene as a part of the curriculum of the students. And to have the online education, the center is planning many things, like Ministry of MHRD, Ministry of Human Resource Development proposes to spend about 2,306 crore on developing the translation of digital course content resource over the next 5 years. On the other hand, MHRD will provide laptops and tablets to 4.06 crore students, and have projected 40% of the projected students will have laptop by 2026, and it will cost around 60,900 rupees, and the largest chunk of it will be received by the laptops and all by 2021 and 2022. And the center share in this scheme will be in the ratio of 60-40, that is the 60% would be given by the central government and 40% would be given by the state government, and 90-10 ratio on the seven northeastern states and Himalayan states. So let's move towards next article. In this there is many data regarding the women empowerment that will form a part of your GS paper, and let's see what here is depicted. So the girls missing globally sex selection has been increased in India, around 46 million out of 146 million according to the UNFPA State of World Population Report 2020. So here point to be noted is UNFPA. UNFPA is published by which agency? That could be a most possible question of UPSC. So you should know that a UNFPA report is released by which agency, that would help you to clear your prelims exam. So the report examines the issue facing by women, like sex selective issue, sex selective abortion and all. So excess of female mortality is difference between the observed and expected mortality of a girl child or avoidable death of girls during the childhood. So as per the report, 2014 cites a 2014 study of India, which have excess female deaths, that is 13 per thousand males, 13 per thousand female births, or 1 in 9 death. So however, the advent of technology has increased, so with the increase of technology, the girls' mortality rate has also increased. How? As the ultrasound and all are available to see the girls' feticide, and so the girl feticide is going on. So let's move towards next article. The World Bank has okayed the Namami Gange Fund worth rupees 3000 crore. So we must know what is Namami Gange project in this regard. And we should also note the point, it is our project which is also funded by World Bank. So it could be a possible question of your prelims exam, that it is totally funded by central government, partially funded by state and the central government, or funded by World Bank along with central and state government. So the third option would be correct here. So Namami Gange project under the National Ganga River Basin project has been implemented under the hybrid annuity model. So we'll discuss about what is hybrid annuity model and also see how the Ganga project is implemented in next slide. So around 1209 crores has been provided by DBOT, design, build and operate and transfer. So what is DBOT? See, hybrid annuity model is a financial terminology in which the payment is made by fixed amount for a considerable period and then variable amount in the remaining period. So hybrid annuity model is a mix of bought annuity model and EPC model in India. So as per the designs, government contributes 40% of the project cost in 5 years through annual payments annuity. So in India we are using DBOT, and it means design, build, operate and transfer. Under this model, we ask the firms to design, then ask the firms to operate, and then collect their revenues and then transfer it to the government of India. So let's move towards next article. Before moving it, we should look from where the river Ganga is originating and what are its key points where it is having its tributaries matching to it. So you must note all these important tributaries which are related to the Ganga River, because many times UPSC ask this question. So please take a snapshot of this diagram. I will be attaching the PDF in the description. So next move is about a plea filed in the Supreme Court. So here plea is filed by senior lawyer Divya Jyoti Singh, and she has asserted that India consumers are still kept in dark, not disclosing the country of origin, as e-portals should have means selectively display the name of country of origin. And in this crisis period, where the China is asserting claims and continuous tensions are rising at the Galwan Valley between India and China, the country of origin must be depicted. So, and as we know that in the stores also, the physical printing, there is a tag of made in India or made in China. So, in this regard, the lawyer has filed a plea. Let's see what happens about the Supreme Court decision. So, recently, the UN Rights Chief has condemned the virus response of China, Russia, and US because they are not able to control the pandemic situation in their respective countries, and they have carved out the situation by suppressing the press, media reports, and manipulating the data. And reports are been coming that there is a frequent violation of the data privacy and data manipulation and international treaties as well. So let's move towards next article. So here in this article, the author is saying that despite opposition from Hong Kong, the security law has been passed. So we should know that Hong Kong was a colony of UK, and it was transferred around 23 years ago to the China. So China is continuously, till now, it was not having full-fledged powers in Hong Kong. It was having a two-state factor, two-state solution in which both autonomous states were there. But now the China is continuously increasing its power and presence in the Hong Kong as well. And the recent act passed by China is in regard to control the violent agitations which are rising there, so that China can carve out the freedoms of people there as well. So let's move towards next article. So in this article, the Palestinian President Mohammed Abbas has asked to India to means see and recognize the Palestine as an independent sovereign country and not suppress it more, and asked Indian government to see that the Palestinians are no more pressed by the Israeli government. But we should not forget that India is also having good relation with Israel. So India has not neither condemned the situation nor India has approved the condition. So let's move towards next article. So herein the author has talked about the Sri Lankan president and Sri Lankan president and bilateral relations of India. So bilateral relations in India with the Sri Lanka are continuously improving, and herein the Sri Lankan government has asked Indian government to have the swap agreement between both the countries, so that the Sri Lanka can repay its debt, as the Sri Lankan government has planned to repay the debt worth rupees $2.9 billion. We don't know how it will be possible, but recently the Sri Lankan government urged the China Development Bank, and it has approved a loan about $500 million towards the Sri Lankan government. So this was only about the Chinese government. So let's move towards next article. The loan recast to only defer problem, not solve it. S&P. So here in the RBI is saying that the estimated gross non-performing asset ratio will rise to 14% in the financial year from 8.5% in the financial year 2020. So we must see that RBI is continuously trying to restructure the tax and all for the continuous improvement in the banking sector, but it is unable to do so because the pandemic situation is too worse, and China as well as all means Indian government is trying to improve itself, but actually it is not improving. So let's move towards next article. So herein, the US Department has said that it is not means promoting any firm for the 5G list, as US government has banned all the Chinese entities from entering to the 5G bit list. And in this regard, the USA has said the partners should adopt strong risk-based 5G security measures to exclude untrusted and high-risk suppliers. Along with that, US has placed restriction on selling the technology from Hawaii, that is China, and being urging the countries, including India, to ban Hawaii from banning the 5G network. So India has banned recently about 59 Chinese apps. We have discussed it earlier. So let's move towards next article. So herein the L&T has means a very great achievement, as engineering and construction giant Lassen and Turbo has achieved a major success in making India, that it has made the cryoset, which is a key part of world largest nuclear fusion reactor, which is made purely in India. The function of cryoset is to provide cooling to the fusion reactor and keep it very high temperatures at core under control. So these 2 points were important from your prelims point of view. Let's move towards next article. So NADA here has launched a mobile application which will provide easy access to information about various aspects of sport prohibited substance and dope testing. So the app is launched by Sports Minister Kiran Rijiju via its conferencing. So you should know about this, that NADA, what is NADA? It's a National Anti-Doping Agency, which aims to promote healthy competition in the athletics as well as all the race events, etc., etc. Let's move towards next article. So herein, a rare critically endangered plant species called Globa androsil, found from Sikkim Himalayas. It is also known as the dancing ladies as well as swan flowers. So global anthills are characterized by white flowers, non-applanted anthers, and various other things. So you should know about the global anthill, that it is a critically endangered species under IUCN. So with this, we have come to end of news discussion. Let's finish the discussion. We will meet in our next lecture. Thank you. Have a nice day.